Three companies will now be in the business of building NASA-sponsored space stations. Blue Origin, Northrop Grumman, and NanoRacks were each awarded contracts ranging from $125 million to $160 million. Like other aspects of space travel and exploration, NASA is looking to private companies to help reduce costs. The station contracts are expected to save the agency about $1 billion. The orbiting stations will be both for private and government use.
The shelf life of the International Space Station is due to expire in 2030. It served very well as an orbiting lab. These next generation space stations will act as labs as well, but will be platforms to go deeper into space.
Travis Thompson worked in the White Room for the majority of the shuttle programs on the team that closed the hatch before launch.
We need another one. I believe it would be called a stepping stone to get to Mars, because I think it would be better to go have a station in orbit that we could leave from to either go to the moon and launch from the moon to Mars or the station to Mars.
There's no talk that the first round of new stations coming over the next 6 years will serve as connections to beyond Earth's orbit, but they will put more people in orbit to study how to go farther. And more good news for the Space Coast. Elon Musk announced today that SpaceX has restarted building a launch pad specifically for the Starship at the Kennedy Space Center. Pad construction started in 2019, but SpaceX then shifted focus to Texas, where Starship test launches were conducted. In Brevard County, Scott Heidler, WESH 2 News.